I am at the Karnataka Smart Cities Investment Summit, and I have Mr. Anjum Parwez, who tells about the idea about the summit. So tell me, what exactly is the idea behind this summit?
See, as you know that in 2015, our smart city project, that's a dream project of our honorable Prime Minister. So 100 cities we had taken at that time, and fortunately Karnataka also gets 7 cities out of that. So in the beginning there are a lot of hurdles, like not only in Karnataka, in fact almost all the states, they face the problem of establishing the special purpose vehicle, then appointment of the project management consultant. But now most of the places the things are on the track now. So the idea of this summit is that we have lot of public-private partnership project which have been taken under the smart city. But not only that, like if you see the entire requirement of urban infrastructure in our country, not only in Karnataka, the requirement of fund is huge. And that kind of fund is neither available with the state or with the urban local body or with the government of India. So the only option with us is that how we can attract the private investment in the urban infrastructure. So it can be any kind of infrastructure like water supply or the underground drainage or the road work, where the private people can come and invest in that, and then the payment can be based on annuity basis, how it is done in the national highway project. That is the one set of project. Other set of projects are commercially viable project, like for example multi-level car parking or commercial complex, where the estate does not have to pay anything. I have the land, the private person will come, invest the money, and whatever is the money they are getting out of the rent, we are going to share with it.
And also it's been almost 5 years since Prime Minister has announced 100 right, smart cities, right. And Karnataka is lucky to get 7 of them.
Right.
So what is the progress in terms of smart cities, sir? I mean, like PPP is one thing, I know which you said investment.
Right.
What are the other things which has to be done, and why it's not as fast as we thought?
No, if I compare myself, Karnataka, with the other states, I don't think that we are behind, because if you see at the national level, estate as such, we are in the rank of 6th or 7th. Sometime we'll go to 6th, sometime to 7th. So that, because every estate is competing with each other. But if you see the individual 7 cities, all my 7 cities are in the top 50 cities. So no, nothing is below 50, and they are at a very
any
good
specific rank. Progress in terms of either Bangalore?
You, like for example, like we have established control and command center in almost all the city now. We have done lot of smart road work have started, then a lot of camera from the security point of view has been taken.
The CCTV security camera.
Lot of work has started on the water supply, how to make it more smart through the smart meters and those kind of things. We are focusing on development of the open parks and spaces, because ultimately in the city you need some place where the people can go with the family and spend time. So like for Shimoga, we are coming up with the riverfront development on the Bhadra River. Similar thing we are going in Mangalore, we are going to develop the beaches itself where people can come with the family. The smart lounges have been done in Tumkur. We are moving on the digital library. So a lot of work have been completed, but only thing I would like to say that this was a complete new concept. It talked about the sustainability. First time we started thinking in terms of the quality of the infrastructure. So road, not just for the doing the road. When you are doing a road, then you should think in terms of 30 years. So we are going with the ducting on the side. A lot of utility shifting is required. That is the major time taking process, because the existing pipeline has to be identified. So that's why I told you, like you go to any estate, any city, the first 2 years was a very, very bumpy ride. But now almost every city is on the track, and it's a very a tough competition among the city that who is staying, because the government of India, very smartly, they keep on showing this ranking of the city, ranking of the estate. So that puts
a lot of pressure on the estate.
Lot of pressure, but I'm very happy to say that yes, we are competing with other estate, and in the coming days, our things will improve further.
Yeah, and also in terms of what are the takeaways from here? Like, you know, a lot of foreign investors have come here, like Israel, you know, a lot of other countries have come.
See, if you see the Karnataka estate engagement with the foreign consulate, whether it is France or Denmark or Israel, the other people also, we are not able to invite each and every person. So it's not that we are interacting with them only for this summit. It's a continuous interaction with them. So if you say, for example, Israel, like November, I had gone to Israel. I spent 1 week time understanding what is they are doing. So they are doing fantastic work as far as the irrigation is concerned, as far as the urban water supply is concerned. So we are trying to bring those technology in our country also, so that we can provide a better services to the people. Like for example, if you go on in Denmark, now Denmark has done excellent work as far as the environmental friendly initiative is concerned. They are working on the climate protection, they are working on the sustainable project, they are working on the green building project and all those things. So we are discussing recently one of the my city, Tumkur city, they have a tie up with one of the Denmark city for city to city interaction. Similarly, if you see the France, there are a lot of big companies, Suez, Veolia, all these companies which are in the UGD sector, water supply sector, infrastructure maintenance sector, in the IT sector. So it's a continuous interaction. But today is, these 2 days, we are all sitting on a single place. So it becomes very easy for the interaction. But otherwise, our interaction with the foreign companies, foreign consulate is perfectly right. And we are trying to engage them, show them that what India is, what Bangalore is, what Karnataka is. It's all about that. Yeah. Okay.
And thank you very much to speak to Smart Sustainability. Thank you. We'll be following it here. Yeah.